Hello. No doubt we're all aware of the fact that COVID-19 cases are on the rise in our area. Bishop Trimble has asked all United Methodist churches in the Indiana Conference to suspend in-person worship beginning this Sunday. The administrative board at Pimento United Methodist Church met Tuesday night and made the tough decision to do this. It was not made lightly, and it was made with a great deal of pain. So, beginning this Wednesday, November 18th, we will suspend all in-person activities at Pimento United Methodist Church. We'll not be having Wednesday night Bible study, and on Sunday, we will not have Sunday school, nor will we gather for worship. At the end of 2 weeks, the leadership will gather the information and evaluate the situation. We did this because we want to exercise an abundant amount of caution. We are aware that people can contract COVID-19 without even being aware that anybody else around them was ill. So we want to not have any cases stem from our gathering together. I'm very aware that this is not something we wanted to see happen. We will continue with our video worship time. It will be a little more than just the sermon. We'll try to include some other aspects of worship and try to have it on Facebook and YouTube on Sunday morning. We'll know more about that as we get closer to that. If you know folks in our church who do not have internet access or not on Facebook, let me know so that we can make connections with them and see how we can help. We're also on in the midst of our annual candy sales, and those forms are due on Sunday, November 29th. Now, there are some options to get those back to the church because we will still be not in session on November 29th. If you have a key to the church, then obviously you can bring yours in and leave it there at the church. If you don't have a key, you can also slip it through that front gap in the front door and we'll get it then. Or you can contact Cheryl Raines for more information on how to do this. It's really sad that we have come to this at this time of year, just getting ready for Advent and Christmas, and often it is at these times that we need each other even more. But let me say this. This will not last forever. We're hearing encouraging news about vaccines and treatments, and we keep hoping and praying that those will be effective and we can get a handle on this. But this will not last forever. There will come a day when we will be able to resume, maybe not normal the way we used to, but we'll be able to resume being together. So I would like to share two passages with you that have always meant a great deal to me when there are trials and tribulations that we all face. The first one is from Isaiah 43. Now, it might not be a familiar passage, but hear these words that God spoke to the prophet Isaiah. But now this is what the Lord says: Do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have summoned you by name. You are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. When you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. Now, this passage really shares with us the fact that trials come our way, that God does not spare us often from trials. But what he does promise is to be with us in them. That the rivers and waters that are turbulent and could sweep us away or could drown us will not be the ultimate end. And that flames won't consume us because God is with us. And then a familiar passage, Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, and my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. We often read Psalm 23 and realize there are some great images of peacefulness, calm green pastures, still waters. But in this psalm are also two references to trying times. Obviously, verse 4, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death. Hear this. God says, even though you walk through. Doesn't say we dwell there. We walk through the valley of the shadow of death. God doesn't promise that we won't go through those times, but he does promise to be with us. And another verse that we might not always think about, but thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. God does not always remove our enemies. God does not always remove the enemies of this life, but he does promise to prepare a table for us, a table, a banquet of Christ. So be encouraged in this time. Again, this, I believe, will not last forever, even though it seems like it. But know that each of you are loved by God in such a profound way that he came to live among us in the person of Jesus Christ, to take on our sin, to die on the cross, and to be resurrected to show us eternal life. So I want you to know that you are loved, and I love you too. God bless till we meet again.